Be prepared to be shocked. It's entirely possible that you have mistakes and research opportunities hiding in your online family tree. Today, I'm going to introduce you to Goldie May, a revolutionary technology that works with a family search trees and in the future will be working with ancestry family trees to show you how to clean those up and make sure they are accurate. Because what's a family tree if it isn't accurate? Do you really want me to answer that question? Now, Goldie May is a 10% Chrome extension and a 90% web application. Basically, you have to go over to the Chrome extension store, type in Goldie May into the search box, and then you will find the application right there. Go through the process of installing it, and then you are good to go to start using this feature to help you visualize the lifespan of your ancestor. So navigate over to the FamilySearch website and then sign in. From the home page, navigate to a profile that you are interested in viewing with Goldie May. I'm going to click this one. Now with my FamilySearch signed in and to a profile, I'm going to come up here to the Chrome extension. Scroll down to the option for Goldie May, and a second narrow window will pop up. So I need to click the sign in button. And since I'm signed in over here, it will be super easy. So now I'm going to come up to the three hamburger buttons at the top and come down to Subway Map. And now you're going to see the Subway Map. Because these are two separate windows, you will be able to drag your window over and view it a little bit better and then switch between the two screens. So now let me introduce you to a number of things that you're going to need to know in order to make this work really well. The first thing that you will want to know are the locations are across this left side. The vertical column and the horizontal line is the timeline. Now, some of you may actually view the locations much smaller on your screen. So if you want to increase the locations readability, you're going to have to use the keys on your keyboard. So if it's an Apple, you will use a Command plus to make bigger, Command negative to make smaller. If you're using Windows, Control plus to make bigger, Control minus to make smaller. So I'm going to make it smaller, but make sure you click on the profile. Make sure it's active. So it'll be a little light blue. You see how it's going from light blue to dark blue, depending on which one I'm activating. And I'm going to go ahead and make it smaller, and I can make it larger, and you can see that the side font is more readable. Couple other things you're going to want to know about the Goldie May tool is that if you click on the left vertical column, if you click on one of the locations, so right now I'm going to hover over Franklin, and then I'm going to get some prompts. If I hover over Ohio, I will get some prompts, and the United States, and get some prompts. So Goldie May is a research tool. So when you hover over the locations, it will give you some prompts to take you directly to some research pages, some research guides, some card catalogs on a variety of different websites and locations. So for instance, there's the FamilySearch Wiki, the FamilySearch Catalog, as well as the Family History Guide. If I click on United States, you're also going to see Find My Past, My Heritage, Ancestry, and a few more. So for Franklin, I'm going to come up here and click on the wiki. And in the browser that had the Family Search profile page, it's going to take me directly to the Franklin County, Ohio wiki page or whatever location that you were looking at. It's really neat. Now, there are a lot of features on Goldie May that you're going to want to learn. I'm going to link to a Goldie May YouTube video that tells you how to do some of these features. Now, let's go and examine those mistakes, I promise. Now, first, if your Subway looks like this, it's probably because you don't have enough information for Goldie May to review. So what you have to do is make sure that you have more facts in Family Search. So here we can see there's a birth date and a place. That's the first dot. The second dot could be a death, but unfortunately all we have is a death date. It doesn't have a location. So if you don't put a location and a date in, then Goldie May cannot plot that point. The other points that you need to add, the other details you need to add, is you need to have facts in this section. And I'll make sure that I highlight that in a different profile here in a moment. But if you don't have facts in this section, residence, military, education, those type of things, if it's not here, then Goldie May can't plot anything. Goldie May will also plot family members. So the spouse, if you put in a marriage date and place, then Goldie May will plot it. And if the person has children and you put in a birth date or a death date for that child, then Goldie May can plot it. So if your plot looks like this, it means that you have some research that needs to be done over here. Now, let's show you a profile that will plot quite nicely. Let's go ahead and go to Matthias. And you can see that there's a lot of things showing up over here. Now, one more thing to keep in mind. When we attach sources to FamilySearch using the source linker, or we create custom sources here, we don't necessarily have the information transfer over to this section. So if you want, let's go back over here. There is a christening and christening of death. If there was a census record, then you need to make sure you come over here and put residence by clicking alternate facts, finding residence, and putting in the date and location where you found that person in a census record for it to be plotted over here on the subway line. So if you do have sources over here that are not showing up in the map, then what you need to do is go back here and clean up the facts, add more details. So let's go ahead and examine this profile. There's a lot of things taking place. When you see a horizontal line, that means the person is staying in this location. This happens to be Essex County, New Jersey, for a long period of time, from 1800 to 1830. When you start seeing some zigzags, it's possible that you have some messes to clean up in your family tree. But if you'll notice, we have Essex, New Jersey, British Colonial America. We have Essex, New Jersey, United States. Well, that is really the same location. Something to keep in mind is that some of the zigzags, which could be potential errors, might be name changes for that location. Now, Goldie May is considering the possibility of kind of grouping locations together, particularly if they have name changes or borders. It's not there yet. But be advised, okay, they're not really moving. The name of the location is changing. So we have this change. We have Union. Now, this could actually be the same place again because Union and Essex split off from one another. But then we have it goes back to Essex, British Colonial America. So what does that tell us? Well, because these are different dates, this is 1773 in Union, this is 1775, you know, the American Revolution began in 1776, so it's entirely possible that this United States really should become British Colonial America. Now, this is in a child's profile, while this is in John's profile. So now you know where the cleanup needs to happen. Not necessarily, excuse me, that's not John, that's Matthias. John is his son. Then we need to go to leave it in Matthias's profile and come down to Susan's profile and make that change to British Colonial America. We have another one in unknown New Jersey, United States. That's for the marriage, and we have some other things taking place. So it's really, this zigzag could mean that there are errors, or it could mean you need some cleanup, Or it could mean it's a research opportunity. Perhaps all you know is New Jersey. Well, now we need to go, can we bring it down to the county level when a child was born or a marriage took place and so on and so forth? It's a pretty fascinating little tool. Here's another mistake that is hiding in your family tree, and it might be a little bit controversial. So when you see this timeline of William Howe, we see that his birth was about 1760. It's really hard to see because my cursor is hovering over it. But 1750, and then his death is in 1794. So 250 years later, there is another event taking place. So let's go over to the profile and see what's going on. So on this profile, we have a birth date and place. We have a christening date, but no place, so that's not going to be plotted. We have a death date and place, so that will be plotted, but we do not see a burial date, so that won't. But when we come down to other information, so in 2003, a descendant of William Howe proved their lineage to this United Empire Loyalist ancestor. But did this really impact William Howe's life? Not necessarily. So in that case, you would probably go back into the affiliate, take out the date and the location, and just put that in the details in the notes section of that event, and then it won't plot on your map and it won't confuse people. So I know that might be a little bit controversial, but I hope you'll understand we're really trying to document the ancestor's life, and something 250 years after is nice, but there's a different way to include that information without making that kind of information pop up on a timeline, both on Goldie May, but also in research reports that are printed out, pedigree charts that are printed out, and other tools that are on FamilySearch. Now, here's an example of a timeline that just shows some migration that might be taking place. So an ancestor was born in Ireland. We're not really sure where, so we leave it that way. And then they are married in County Tipperary. They have a child born in Ireland before they go to New York, but they're not entirely sure where. So this would be a research opportunity for that child, try to figure out where that child might have been born. So coming down to New York, and they pop across to Massachusetts, and they come and live in New York before migrating to Michigan. Now, if you look over here in this lower left-hand corner, you can see the option to change this to offer more details, because right now it's the state and country level, and probably this New York and Massachusetts, what if they are borders? So they're close to get related. People can go back and forth across the border, or there's a boundary change. That's a reasonable explanation for the change. But what we're going to do is we're going to come down and see that we have unknown New Yorks, Warren, New York, Worcester, Massachusetts, more unknowns taking place here. And if we could try to resolve where these children were born more specifically, that would be very helpful in cleaning up this timeline. If we go to the city, county, state level, it doesn't change all that much. We still have some of those unknown city locations. But let's see if we can possibly get the county resolved. And then we have more of those horizontal lines rather than the zigzags. Now that I've shown you several examples of subway lines where you can see that you have either research opportunities or cleanup work to do in your FamilySearch family tree, let me show you this one, which is a good example of migration in a family tree. So first, they start off in New York City. They move to Polk County, Wisconsin, Winnebago, Wisconsin, and then a final location in Wisconsin. That is a nice line of how people migrate through through life and through locations. And when you see something like that, it means that your tree and the facts that you have added are in good condition. Now, this video doesn't even scratch the surface of how awesome this tool is when it works with FamilySearch. This tool can also overlay a timeline from Ancestry and FamilySearch so that you can see whether those two aligned well or not and which information needs to migrate from the two different profiles. You can also overlay multiple people to see how the family migrates through life, to see if it overlaps. You can use this tool when merging. You can use this tool with source leaking. You can use this tool to do so many things. At the time of this recording, I talked to Richard, the owner of Goldie May, and he said there's really a lot of tools that are coming online for Ancestry, but I don't have enough time to put it in this video. So here's the deal. If you want to learn more about the Goldie May Subway tool or any of the really cool tools such as the auto research log, oh yeah, I hate research logs, but they have me liking their research log feature. If you want to hear about them, then you need to like this video, comment in the comments section, and share this with everybody. So the more traffic this video gets, the more Goldie May videos I will do in the future. So everything rests on your shoulders. If you want more tips and tricks on how to clean up your family tree, be sure to check out that video right up there, and we'll see you next time.